This iconic screen is the tile start menu for Windows 8 8.1. Here you can get to your documents, your programs, your pictures, your music. On the right-hand side here, you can see I can get to all of my Office programs, including OneNote. But with Windows 8.1 and Windows 8, there is an app store. And at the app store, you can get apps that cost a few bucks or are free. And one of those is a OneNote app. Now, much like we have a OneNote app for an Android phone or an iPad, we have a OneNote app that's built especially for Windows 8.1. So that's what we're going to talk about today. You can get it from the store. Now, anyone can use this app that'll open up here now, but it's built for touch devices especially. So I'm on a two-in-one device here, but I'm going to try to use all touch here today, like it was in the tablet mode. I'm going to change it around and get set here. And so what you're seeing here is the OneNote Windows Store app, and it's just had a big upgrade last week. We're going to show you some of those features. One of this is the look that you're seeing right now. You see your most recent notes first. If you haven't seen this, my notebooks are on here on the left-hand side. So here's my notebook here. I also have other notebooks. You could have them on your computer. You could have them in SkyDrive. You could have them, if you're in business, on your SharePoint or SkyDrive Pro site. And they all show up in the same place. That's why, again, I use this every day because it's got home and work all combined. It's easy to get to. Each notebook has sections, and then each of those have pages. One thing with the pages that's new with this app is you get a little preview of each of your pages if it has any type of illustration, so you can quickly go to what type of page that you want. Because this is touch, I can use touch on my screen, so I can make things bigger with two fingers, and so I can see something in really big. And I can, you know, shrink things back down. And you notice kind of the UI kind of goes out of the way. I can get it back by touching those three lines at the top, those three horizontal lines. That gets me the kind of the UI. Or when I start writing or working on the page, that UI goes away. So let's get in and do some, work. Let's go to this team meeting. I can start working on this with a touch computer here if I want to. So if I have my touch screen, I can do it. And as you can see, the words actually are appearing kind of like they do on a phone. Also, if you notice, anytime you touch, you get this round icon. And that is the touch menu especially built for this Windows Store app. So if you touch it, it brings up a radial menu and you get suggestions of what you want to do. Now, that works differently on where you are in the writing. So if I'm over here and I'm working with text, let's say I want to change this paragraph in here, I get this A. I click on that with a finger, and I get that menu that has more items that deal with text, font size, so to speak. If I go into a table here, I get a table icon. Click on that. Opens up table options, including if I wanted to insert a row, I could do that. Insert right. So I could add information here if I wanted to. If you touch the screen, you get this little smaller circle next to your text, and then you can drag that to work on an area. So I'm going to take this whole table here, click on this icon, and I can use different fonts, colors. Let's change the font on this. Let's change the font size. And I get this little thing that looks like a speedometer. That's actually, I can just move that with my finger and change the font size. Let's change it up to 20. Make it nice and big. Yeah, it's a little big. It's 19. Let's go down a little bit. 16. Press the arrow back. If I want to change the color, I can swipe up. And that gives me the color, and you can see there's different colors I can swipe here. And I just go through the arrows at the bottom. And so I can get different shades of green or red that I want. Let's go with blue. And I can pick any shade of the blue rainbow I want. Let's go with purple, since that's the OneNote color. And it changes your font, goes to purple there. As you work with this radial menu, there are shortcuts. If you notice here, undo, if I wanted to undo something, that's to the left-hand side. I can touch that and undo. But if I just go to this menu first time, undo was at the 9 o'clock position, and I can just swipe to the left and it undoes it, if that's the right word. Undoes it, undo it. I don't know about that. let me show you something else you can use here. Let me go over to a project here. I click on this one. I can click over here to the right-hand side and get the menu. And I get my draw menu that I have pens. I can preset four pens. And so I can draw in here. So if I want to make notes on a slide or something like that, I can simply draw. That's kind of a weak line. So let me get something stronger here. Let me go to this pen. Let me pick thick. Let me pick thick red pen. Because everyone loves a thick red pen, don't they? So now I can go over here and draw and make notes here. Probably do a thinner pen on this one here. And write anything I want to. No. I'm in management, so I can just write no, and they'll understand what I'm saying. So you can use the pens, even though you don't have the pen that works with the computer, the actual physical one. You can use the drawing in OneNote to work on your items or make notes or make drawings. I mean, if you go back here, we have some of our sample pages here as people use drawings or use pictures to tell their story. So importing, of course, putting things into OneNote is what a lot of people work on. So let me show you how you can share with that. I'm going to show a little bit of the way Windows 8 is used for touch. To get to menus, you can swipe up. That's the OneNote menu. It gives you some figure if you have paper options if you want to, or you can go some commands. You can then, if you go in from the right, and I'm just swiping with my thumb, you can see that you get the charms. Now the charms are for, you get that on any time you swipe in from the right-hand side on Windows 8.1. If I hit click settings, that bottom one there in the bottom right-hand corner, the bottom settings, I get those all the time. That's screen, sound, connectivity, things like that. But the settings at the top are for the program that's open. So here's how I could change my options for OneNote. I could add accounts, things like that. So I'm going to swipe from the right to get my charms and click share. And I can do a couple different things here. I can share screens with folks in email or whatever. That's how I can send this page to folks. Let me pick a page here. It's got a little more. So I can click share and I can send mail. This is the mail app that's in Windows 8.1, which has also improved very well. It was improved greatly. Try it. It's improved. On Windows 8.1 on touch device, if you swipe in with your left side, with your left thumb, you can cycle through the pages that are open here. So here's a sports page, kind of talking about the Seahawks victory here. Hope you saw that. I wanted to get an app I thought I had open, but I'm going to go to my main menu here. And click, this was a new 8.1 app called Food and Drink. And it has a recipe of the day. Let's see what that is. It's a quiche. And if I wanted to keep this recipe, again, swipe from the right-hand side, click share. I want to share this with OneNote. And then I hit the little send button here at the upper right-hand corner. I can pick whether if I want to send it to the current page that's open or the notebook. I'm just going to send it to the My Stuff section of the notebook. Now, it's going to work on some apps better than others, but if you ever want to make a screenshot, you can do that. Let's open up, let's go back here and open up a page. Let's say I was comparing some things at office.com, and I'm going to go compare plans. And if I just want to screenshot that page, I think if I just hit the share button here, it would just send a link. Let me see what that would look like here. Again, it just sends the link to it, which is okay information, but if I want to capture that, I can swipe, click share, and then at the top here, I can just grab a screenshot with OneNote, and I'll send that to OneNote. I'll show you what these look. Let me go back and after this share is over. There's the screenshot I just added, and you can see I can zoom in if I want to on it. Read that information. Also, screenshots that are clear like this, that text will be searchable. I'll show you that in just a moment. And here's the quiche recipe. So again, sharing is one thing that you can work on with swiping in from the right-hand side and using your charms. Let's show a little bit more of the capabilities that were upgraded for this. If you're doing business travel, you do a lot of things with receipts. And whiteboards and meetings. I'm going to do both things for you. Let's first talk about meetings here. A lot of times when you're doing it with means, you're in a room like this and you have a whiteboard, and at the end everyone takes the snap with the whiteboard, and you know, what do you do with it? It stays on your phone, it stays on your camera. Here you can actually put it into the page. Now, if something like a Surface Pro that has a camera that's on the outside, I could just pick up my laptop and snap the picture and put it back. I didn't want to do that for this demo. I didn't want to move this computer as much as possible. So I'm just going to add a picture that I took earlier of a whiteboard. So I'm going to open up my pictures, and here's a typical shot of a whiteboard. And again, it's a bad angle. It's angled away from what I'm doing. It's just something I shot. It's pretty yellowish from the color. But if you notice on the left-hand side here, there are some options on this screen as I'm in OneNote adding it. And I click the middle one, I can tell OneNote, is this a photo, a document, or a whiteboard? It's a whiteboard. And it kind of does a little magic of re-rendering the device. So it kind of flattens out the text and everything. So this is a little more readable. Now, it's trimming off a little bit. So let me go into, I can crop this. And yeah, it looks like it's just kind of cutting off a little of this text. So with my fingers, there are these anchors that I can just make that text a little bigger and click OK. But again, it's on an angle here. And now it's flat, white. I can read that text a lot more clearly. There's some other lines in there, but the main part is there. And then I can insert that on the page that the meeting notes are on in my OneNote. Everything's in one place. Let's show this one more place and show you some of this kind of magic that we have for this Windows Store app. Let's add receipts. So a lot of times you want to keep your receipts. Again, if I had a Surface Pro, I could just take a picture of that receipt, plop it right in here. I'm going to touch the screen, insert, and I'm going to insert a picture of a receipt. And I got a couple here I'm going to do. I took the same receipt two different ways to show you what this works like. So I'm going to open up both of these. This one has a nice, when you have like a whiteboard that has a dark background, it's going to capture it much better. So this receipt has a dark background of the table I took it on. So I'm going to go over to the left-hand menu. This is a document, so I'm going to click that. And he immediately cuts all the background, flattens everything out. I get a really crisp look at that text. Let's look at this other picture I took. I crumpled it up, not in good light. The background's kind of the same color. Well, it's not as sharp of a contrast. Same thing, if I press document, it tries to read it. Now it makes a bit of a close-up, but again, I can recrop this picture if I want to. It's because the paper is crinkled and all that. But again, I can change all that by using these little finger anchors. Yes, I need this to capture that information. And it makes a nice close-up of that. And then I can see these. I'm going to insert both of these into my OneNote. So there they are. I can shrink these down just like I can a picture by using these anchors. So if I want to. Now, because that writing is nice and crisp, that's also searchable. So let me go back to my charms, swipe from the right, click search. I can search anywhere on my computer here, but I just want to search OneNote. I'm going to search for, let's say, the word salad. If you look in the receipt in the middle of the screen, salad is actually yellowed out. It actually found that word and is highlighting that word for me. On the left-hand side is all the other pages that are in OneNote that has the word salad. That's how you don't have to really organize everything in OneNote. It's all searchable, and you can find things. So if I was looking for that spicy orange salad, I could, you know, click on that and immediately go to that recipe that I had on another page from another time. Again, if you just know, just a few words, you can find anything in OneNote. And you can find it anything from a screen clipping to any clear writing that you've taken a picture of. Now, it's not going to find those words in the whiteboard, but it will find those notes in something like a receipt. So that kind of wraps everything up for taking a quick note at the OneNote, the Windows Store app for OneNote. It's free. Go to the Windows Store. You search for OneNote. You can find it. We have a link for you also. If you go to aka.ms/note123, you can find all the links for things we talked about, even some in more information about the Windows Store app, links to just OneNote help in general. We'll have the video up here in an edited format. a little bit later this week. If you need any information or have any questions about the Office webinar series in general, go to aka.ms/offweb. There you'll find our homepage and find links to previous webinars. That is it for today's webinar. Next week, we're going to be showing you the top 10 things about Office. It's the end of the year, so you have to have a countdown show. We'll do that next week. But for today's Office webinar team, thank you for joining this Office 15-minute webinar.